Hello guys, how you are doing? Today we are going to create knit fabric in our APEXFiz Design Junior. And with this, we are going to make this knit block sweater that I like a lot. I am also planning to make one for myself, but for this I have to purchase some wool. Well, let it be, for the future I will try to share it with you if somehow I will be able to make it. For now, we will create one here online. So without any delay, join us in today's class. To create weave, we use this section of software. But for creating knit, we have to go there. New. Here, you can name your new knit and also decide the gauze of this from texture. Here I am going to select 5 gauze. After this, wait for another dialog box to open. Here you can decide the size of your knit and you can also change the unit as per your need. Here you can also decide the color of your knit. After deciding everything, you will see a block like this. I know you might be thinking, where is the knit? But wait my friend, you have to select loop edit from here, where you can change some basic settings again if you need, and press OK after this. Now you will be able to see that knit appearance. Here in new, they have various preset design that can be edited later for customization. Similarly, we have pattern here which consists this type of designs. Now I will be using knit from new section only. All you have to do is to select your knit and then you will get a preview. You can press left mouse button wherever you need that to be placed. I am going to create some V shape here, so I am going to select the similar design of opposite side. Since we need this V shape all over, so we will select repeat from here and make decent fill of our design in this block. I am satisfied with this placement, so let me press done. We are back to our old window, but wait, where is all the work we have done? Don't get hyper, all we need to do is select loop simulation like we have for woven fabric. Here we have similar change but according to knit fabric. Here I want to add randomness, so I will make it 5%. After executing, here we will change our yarn and even the color of it if required. This is our simulated knit, and if you are not satisfied with the result, you can simulate it again with the new settings. To save this image, go to save and select image. After this, we will decide its saving location, file type and many other things. Here in the knit, we don't get the option to export its other map. But I must say, the quality of the knit is too amazing. I need to create same knit but with another color, so I am going to do this from execute only. This color combination is kind of satisfying, so I will export this as well. Now it's time to create rib for our sweater. I will set everything in same way, but this time I am going to set its color to white, since I can't decide the color of our rib right now. Go to loop edit again and set new design from here, which can be used as rib. This one looks fine, so we shall repeat it over this area. After this, we can use loop simulation and change the knit yarn and its thickness. Save this knit now. Since the image is saved in JPG format, so we have to clear the background of all knit by using Photoshop. I will use the color range to do this. Let me clear everything quickly so that we can go ahead. You can even use any other software, but I am comfortable with Photoshop, that's why I am using this software. Now, we are in Clo3D to create block sweater by using the fabric we created in APEXFiz Design Junior. For this, I am going to create a square of 5 by 5 inches and will repeat the shape 8 times. After this, rotate the pattern at a 90 degree and make a copy of it like I created. 4 columns for front and 4 columns for the back and 3 by 3 block for the sleeve. I will set the middle row of the sleeve in between like we have in normal pattern. Now everything is in front of it so we can sew the pattern easily. After sewing half portion, we can make mirror copy of it and make our work easy, since we don't have to sew the other side again. Now, sew the left out area and arrange the pattern in 3D window. After this, simulate it and set over the avatar. Currently, we haven't sewed it up from the side, so we will do that now, slowly. Now, we will apply our one knit texture as our fabric all over the pattern. We have to adjust the texture of all, so let me do that in fast forward. After this, instead of making normal map, I will slide it from here to add some realism. After this, make another copy of it where we can apply other color knit. After selecting everything, we have to select those pattern where we need that to be. So we are making check pattern for that, select accordingly. Crisscross, criss. All set now, it's time to add rib here. We have to calculate it, so 4 rectangle of 5 by 5 inches, which means 20 inches width rectangle, and I will make it 1.5 inches in height. Create a copy for other side. I have applied our rib fabric over 2 pattern already and now I have to decide the color of it. I will try teal color first. Rib size is looking big to me, so I will adjust that. Now, sew this one portion by M&N free sewing tool to check out if our decision is right. It seems nice, so I will make another copy of it, which can be used for the back area. I have to reduce its width size since one square is only 5 inch. Arrange your pattern in 2D window to avoid any mistake and sew that small rectangle to its place. Now we have to connect these two rib pattern. It looks like our sewing is turned, so let me reverse it. Now we can join the two pattern by the help of merge. Do the same to the other side and simulate it. While checking from 3D window, get its stitching done as well. After some adjustments of placement, we are ready to show you the outcome. I hope you like this class, and if you did, do like this video so that we can create more informative videos in future. Subscribe to our channel and also press the bell icon for the new trick and tutorial. Till then, keep creating. Bye.